So this is the first day I will ever have tried an ankle holster as a backup gun. Still have my Glock 19 as my primary at the 430 position inside the waistband, but I got this Galco holster for the Smith & Wesson Shield, actually for my wife's Smith & Wesson Shield, and I'm going to try it first. We'll see how we like it. So I never even put one of these things on. Okay, something like this. Seeing it first here, folks. Maybe it has to go in the holster first. Doesn't really seem like it truly covers the... I mean, it covers the trigger. You know what? Maybe it just has to be broken in a little bit more. Ah. Well, it's nice and tight. Why? Because this is the first time a gun's really even been in there. Wow, it's gonna kind of be tight. So, let's see here. Okay, I've got it on. Pretty comfortable. I'm not sure how much it's printing or not printing. I'm sure just like when you first start carrying inside the waistband, I'm gonna be more paranoid than I probably even need to be. Nobody's gonna be looking for a gun on my ankle. Except for the people who watch this video and see me later on today. I just got home from doing my ankle holster carry. First time ever. And I did it all morning at work for about 6 hours or so. And I noticed when I left the house, it was pretty snug, but it was very secure. And then after a couple hours of standing, I started to not lose feeling in my foot, but just that feeling like it's a little bit too tight around the bottom of my leg. And my foot was... starting to feel like something, like there was a cuff above it. So I loosened it up a little bit and the holster shifted down and it started to wiggle just a little bit more. So what I'm trying to say is I don't think I found the sweet spot yet. But if you just want to take a look down here, I still really like it. I found that when I did sit down this morning, it might have come up to like about there, but I mean, I don't really think you could tell what that is. I know a lot of guys that do the ankle carry wear, shoes or boots that might come up to here instead, and then the holster kind of sits on top of that, so I might try that. I don't really have anything like that right now, but it might be a time to get it. It's sort of a little bit like when you first start doing inside the waistband carry, you switch around your wardrobe. Some shirts that you have work and some just don't work anymore or whatever. Like now I like to wear these shirts that, you know, are a little bit looser and hang a little bit lower so that, you know, I really have to do something kind of crazy. I don't even know if you can see it there, but the cool thing is that when I was driving, it seemed like I could get to it really, really easily. I've tried some appendix carry stuff recently, and I loved how easy it was to draw. I love that aspect of it, but it just didn't really seem to work very well. It wasn't super comfortable for me after a couple days, and I just couldn't, there was just this handle sticking out here all the time, whereas I don't really like to print at all, and I don't really think that prints, and this thing doesn't print really either. The appendix carry thing I really liked because I could get it out like while sitting in the car or whatever, whereas this all the way back here would be kind of hard to get to. But when I'm sitting and you know, my left foot is up here, it's super easy to get to this in the car because it's like it's even easier than I'm showing right now because it's even closer, so I could unsnap that and pull that out for if I ever needed it when I was driving or in some other kind of seated position. But anyway, so far so good. I'm going to try tweaking a couple things and see what happens.